Hey guys, welcome back to Food and Travel with Festive Forever. I'm Tejasvi and today we are in BKC. Near Saigon is a recently opened restaurant which is inspired by Vietnam local bars and colonial restaurants. In my knowledge, this is the first Vietnam restaurant in Mumbai. So let's explore this delicacy. Begin our vlog with meats, which is the specialty of this restaurant. So can you just put them here?
Sure. So this is the nectar. It's the pure form of meat made up of honey. This would be geisha, that is peach and basil flavored.
Okay, peach and basil.
Yeah, this is potion ivy. This is wild fermented. It's okay. With hibiscus. This is hoppisaurus made with hop seed. This is the beer which we brew. It's made of rice.
And rice
this
beer.
Special tap on the meat, that's hop raspberry.
Okay, this is like the special, today's special, right? So guys, the speciality of this restaurant is that they change one tap every day. So if there are six taps, then the one tap is like a today's special, like how in menu there are the specialties of weekend, weekday, Sunday. So that way every day they change one tap, which is like something that never happened. I'm gonna begin with nectar. It's more like a beer actually. Now let's taste the other one. This is little on the sweeter side. It's a little bitter. Bitter and sweet. I like this one. This is sweet and nice. Now let's try the rice beer. So guys, all of them are pretty good, but I think this one would work for me, which is made from raspberry and hops. So I guess I liked it, but I think you have many choices to choose from, and I have already told you all the flavors and tastes that it contains. So it depends on individual to individual. I like this one, you might like something different. So to enjoy this delicacy, the first thing that we have called over here is called Ban Trang. Ban Trang is like a pizza, but then it's made from rice paper. Basically a thin sheet of rice which is grilled on charcoal. As we can see here that this is like a rice paper which is very thin in nature, and then it's char grilled. Let's see, let's just flip it over a little without spoiling anything. So this is burnt, or you can say that it's char grilled, which is gonna give a nice taste. And then all the sauces, vegetables are added on the top. Let's go ahead and take a bite. Actually really good and tasty. They have added sauce, garlic, like the burnt garlic, and then soya chunks. Basically they call that mock meat or something like that, but it's so good. And with the spicy sauce, actually it's more like a tomato chili sauce, which is very tasty, and garlic is giving a brilliant taste. And on top they have added some greens. Loved it. The dish is so amazing and tasty. This white, I think this could be white sauce, but bahut hi badhiya taste, and I loved it. Yum. Whenever you come here, you have to have it immediately, otherwise it will get soggy. It's like a thin sheet, it's a paper sheet, very crispy and brilliant. papaya salad. We all know that this dish is very much famous in Vietnam, and I think everyone loves this, so we had to try it. Now let's look at the ingredients. The base is of papaya, then they have added chili oil, tamarind, peanuts, burnt garlic and onions. I meant the fried onions, and they have also used sour peas, which are like something different. So let's go ahead and try it. Sour, salty, peanuts are giving nice crunch to it. Burnt garlics are giving very nice taste. फ्राइड अनियन का उतना टेस्ट नहीं है. दिस इज़ अ वेरी रिफ्रेशिंग सैलेड. थोड़ा सा ठंडा भी है, एंड पीनट्स की वजह से उसमें जो क्रंच आ रहा है ना, आई एम जस्ट लविंग दैट. एज आई मेंशन अर्लियर, इट्स लिटिल सार एंड सॉल्टी. इट्स नॉट स्पाइसी एट ऑल, बट आई एम लविंग इट. इट्स वेरी डिफरेंट एंड टेस्टी. लेट्स ट्राई समथिंग इंटरेस्टिंग. This dish is called Chow Tom, and I feel that this dish is very unique and different. So let's have a look. This is lettuce and then some herbs, some sprout beans, some red chilies, sesame oil, and this is something which is very interesting. So what they have done is they have used sugarcane stick, added all the vegetables, fried and char grilled. Looks interesting and the concept is very different. So basically we have to remove this thing from the skewer. Alright, it's a little oily. I'm gonna separate just and put this into the small lettuce leaf that we have, like certain amount of it, and then I'm going to add these herbs, some sprouts, spring onion, red chili. I think I added little extra, so I'm gonna use one more leaf to roll it properly. Let's dip this into sesame oil. I think they have added soya sauce in it. Let's try it. So it's a little sweet, then it's also sour and spicy. Actually the spiciness would hit you at the end. First you'll feel that it's a little sour and salty, then you'll feel that it's a little sweet, and at the end you'll taste the spiciness, which is like yummy. You know what, I feel that this dish would taste better with chicken. So if you are someone who eats chicken, then I think you should go ahead and try the chicken skewer, because chicken goes very well with lettuce and it would taste yum. So I'm just gonna go ahead and take a bite directly of these vegetables. Actually these are like mixed fried vegetables with sweet corn, and at the end if you feel that the dish is very spicy, then you can just chew on your sugarcane. In Maine we have raw mango and pumpkin curry along with some steamed rice. So let's serve ourselves. Let's take a little amount of rice and some pumpkin curry. First thing first, it's very aromatic and fragrant. Now let's go ahead and try it. Okay, so this curry is very much similar to our green Thai curry with lemongrass, coconut and little bit of spiciness. It's time to enjoy our dessert called Hopanoi. At first glance I really loved it because it's very very pretty. So it's like a cake Look at the presentation, guys. It's so pretty. So for the base, they have used wafer biscuit and then some chocolate layered. I think it's like a brownie or just, you know, a sponge of chocolate and then some whipped cream, like the chocolate one and the white one. Then some honey or some sauce. Probably this is caramel sauce and then some fruits. Now let's go ahead and just try this biscuit. So it's going to be a little difficult for us to break it. Let's try this yummy biscuit. So I'm just going to take some. So I'm just going to take some fruits and cream from here. Yummy, yummy. I think what I'm going to do is just lift this and eat it. I think their combination is just amazing. Some whipped cream, fruits, caramel sauce, and this biscuit. Too good. So guys, now it's time to rate this place on my festive meter. The place is so beautiful. It's small in size, or you can say that it's compact but very cozy, and the ambiance is just beautiful. The staff is very friendly. They will suggest you with the food. I really enjoyed the food. The food is very much different from our usual cuisine or our Indian cuisine. This is the Asia's first meats tap room. In the sense, there are many places which serves meats, but it's the first place that serves very fresh and right from the taps your meats. If you're somebody who likes to try or enjoy meats, then you're definitely going to enjoy this place. Even the chef Nikhil was very kind and very helpful, introducing to the food, the delicacy, explaining every single thing. I think I enjoyed my experience. It was worth a try. I'm gonna rate this place 10 on 10 on my festive meter. So guys, the place is brilliant. I hope you visit this place. If you do, please don't forget to tag me on my Instagram, that is festiveforever4. If you're new to my channel, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. If you like cooking, then you can subscribe to my other channel, that is Festive Forever. So guys, I guess I'm gonna end my vlog over here. See you in my next vlog. Till then, live life festive style. Bye bye.